Before you complain about your job, remember that some people don't have any job in lockdown. Before you complain about your life, remember that many people are dying in COVID-19. So please, be thankful for a minute when God gave you another day to live, see and breathe. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Peak Life, and I know some of you have already guessed what today's video is all about. So today's topic is, be grateful for what you have. So here I am back with awesome and quality content. This video will teach you a very important lesson of your life. It will change your life completely. It will give you a positive outlook towards your life, which is hard to find with COVID-19 and lockdown. And after watching this video, you will find many things to be grateful for. We human beings always complain. We also compare ourselves with one who is more fortunate than us. But we are not grateful for things we have that others may wish. We never see the one who is less fortunate than us. That's the problem. We are not grateful. And that's the reason we are sad and unhappy. We are not grateful for things we have. It's very easy to focus on burdens than on gifts. To see things you don't have rather than the things you have. Rex King has brilliantly written in his book, Good Wife, Good Life, by counting your blessings daily, you can begin to condition your mind to look for the good in everything around you. Soon enough, you will unconsciously begin to see the bright side of things and feel better about life. Let me tell you the story of Seema, who was a woman of 30 and lived in Mumbai with her husband and 2 kids. Her husband was an office worker and had enough salary to manage all their expenses. The problem with Seema was that she was never happy. She always used to complain about everything. She always used to see her friend Smita and get jealous about her rich and comfortable life. She was never grateful for things she had. She never had anything positive to say. Because of her this habit, people would distance themselves from her. In front of her house lived 2 children who were very poor and lived on footpath. One was a 10-year-old boy who went to work at day and returned at night. He had a small brother of 5 years. They both slept on footpath every day. Seema used to see them every day through the kitchen window. Both of them were always happy, and whenever she looked at them, they always smiled back. On a rainy morning when she was all alone at home having coffee, she started complaining about rain and her life as usual. She became extremely sad and complained to God why she had such an unhappy life. A few seconds later, her eyes fell on the 2 poor children in front of her house and was surprised what she saw. She saw that the 2 poor children were dancing, laughing and screaming with joy in the rain. They were full of joy and energy from head to toe, though they were completely drenched. The rain, the hunger and coolness didn't matter to them. They were wet but happy. She envied their happiness. She also remembered that they were hungry from 2 days. The scene she saw forced her to see at her own life. She realized that she had so many comforts, none of which they had. But they had the most important of all assets, one which she lacked. She knew how to be happy with life as it was. She realized that she had more things to be grateful for than most people could imagine. That a kind husband who respected her so much, to loving and caring children, a nice house, however small, but of her own, proper food and clothes, etc. From that moment, she became a very cheerful, happy and positive woman. Her attitude towards life became a positive one. She started to find happiness in every small thing, in every situation and every person. She also found an NGO that helped poor children and sponsored their education. She admitted both of them in that NGO because she felt sorry for them and wanted to help them. She was then always grateful for everything she had in life and thanked God every day for giving her such a beautiful life. She learned a very important lesson in her life, a lesson she will never forget. It is to be grateful for what you have. And here our beautiful story ends. This story has a very big meaning. Don't complain about everything. At least you have your basic facilities provided to you. You have safe drinking water, 3 times milk to eat, good clothes to wear, a proper roof on your head, and you study in a proper school. You should be grateful that you have loving and caring parents who love you beyond limits. Some children are so unlucky that they do not have parents. Some people are specially challenged or born disabled. At least you have your whole body working properly. Some people have various dangerous diseases. At least you do not have. People die every day due to some reason. And you know how many people have and are dying in COVID-19. At least God has kept you safe and sound. Be grateful and thank God that you got another day to live, see and breathe. Another day to see a rising sun and a beautiful moon. Because some people go to sleep the previous night and die in their sleep. They don't wake up in the morning. Some people have life like hell. If you don't have anything to be grateful for, then fine. I read a line from the book, Good Wife, Good Life, that really stuck with me. The line said, remember, there might be many things in your world that are going wrong. Yet, there are also many things that are going right. Rex King has also said in his book, if you want to practice gratitude, imagine how different your life would be without that particular thing you are showing thanks for. It will produce strong feelings and emotions. And this is how you can get into a powerful state of gratitude. Remember this important lesson of your life. Be grateful for what you have. The more you count your blessings, the more blessings you will have to count. From book, Good Wife, Good Life, written by Rex King. I have many things to be grateful for. And I thank God that I got another day to live, see and breathe. And also to make this awesome video for you. What do you have to be grateful for? Please tell me about it in the comments below. If this awesome video provides you with quality content, for more, please subscribe my channel. And do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you can be the first one to see my awesome videos. Also, like this video and share it to at least 5 people. Thank you.